Welcome programmers, welcome to my kitchen. Happy New Year 2020 to all of you. Today I'm continuing the PureBasic 101 series, and this time I will talk about conditional keywords, which one, if and select. Yes, we are using them all the time, but just quick reminder about those two. Let's start. So, if and select. Let's first start with the if. So, in the if keyword family, we have if, else, and else if, and end if. If is used in almost all programming language. It's a very important keyword because it lets you switch between two execution paths. If you want to execute a piece of code only if one condition is met, you're using the if keyword. How does it work? If you write if an expression, the expression will be evaluated. If the expression is true, the code within the block will be executed. The code will be executed is between the if and the end if keyword, okay? Just like this. If expression is true, execute this code, and if this execute this code function will be executed only if the expression is true, is actually true. If you want to execute another piece of code if the expression is false, then you can use the else keyword. Okay, you write it like this: if expression, code, else, some other code, end if. The execute this code will be executed just as above if and only if the expression is true, is actually true. But if it's false, then the execute that code will be executed. Okay. You can nest as many if, else, end if blocks as you want, just like this. If something, if something else, if some, etc., etc. You can nest as many ifs as you want. But be careful, a Boolean logic can be a little bit tricky. So try not to nest too many. Here it's very precise. You see, if expression A is true, if expression B is true. So here you execute A and B. So when you're here, both A and B are true. Here, A is true, but B is not. Here, A is true, and no matter what is B, true or false, this code will still be executed. And then in the else, meaning A is false, you can add another if C is true. So in that case here, execute not A and C means it's this code will be executed only if C, if C is true and A is not. So this can be very messy very fast. To simplify a little bit this kind of nesting blocks, you can use the else if keyword, okay? So the else if is basically what we call syntactic sugar. It replaces an else and within it an if block. So if you have an else block and within this else block you only have another if block or if else block, then you can use the else if keyword. This will reduce nesting, but the main logic will stay the same. So you can use it like this: if expression A is true, else if expression B is true. Here the execute that code will be executed only if A is false and B is true. Else, so you can still at the end of the block add the else, but the else will be executed only if all expressions that all the expression that you put in your if and all the else if are false. Here, only if A and B are false will this code be executed. The equivalent of this code is not using else if blocks is this one. So you see here you have only one level of nesting and you have less lines of code than here. You have two more lines and one extra level of nesting. So it's cleaner to use this form, but it's exactly, logically, it's exactly the same as this one. Short circuit, yes. Be careful when you're using if blocks. The expression, the Boolean expression in your if can be short circuit. What does this mean? This means that if you have an or an AND operator, the evaluation might stop at the first operand. Okay? For an or here, if the first operand is true, we already know that the whole expression will be true. Okay? So the second operand will not even be evaluated. Okay? The runtime will not execute here. So in our case, I initialize A to be 10. If A equals 10 or test something, execute this code. Because A equals 10, this A equals 10 is true, meaning the whole or expression here is true, but the test something will not be called. So if you are incrementing stuff, if you are changing some variables in the code that is, for example, in the test something function, let's say you are incrementing a counter, be careful. In this case, this will not be called and your counter will not be incremented. Same for an AND keyword, the AND, a logical AND. If the first operand is false, then the second one won't be evaluated. Of course, if the first operand is false, then we know that the whole expression will be false. So the runtime doesn't even try to evaluate this. In our case, test something is not going to be called here. Okay, done with the if and if block. But now the select. Why using a select? Well, in my mind, I think that if you are using an if, else if, with many else if, always testing the same expression, then you should use a select. For example, if you say if A equals 5, else if A equals 10, else if A equals 12, else if A equals 20, and if, or else, then it's a very good case to use the select block. So select, you write a little bit differently. It's a select case default and select, okay, with four keywords. You write select expression. So in our case, select A. And then you put case, value, case, value, case, value, okay? So for each value, you can execute some code. So in our case, select A, case 1, case 2, case 3, okay? You can put some code. And the default is basically the same as your else in an if block. If it's not one of the value you already put in a case, then it will go in the default block and the default, the code here will be executed. This select and select block is exactly the same as this if and if expression here, well, block. Logically, it's the same, but there is a main difference is that in the select here, the expression will be evaluated only once, only once. So if you're calling a function, it will be called only once. But in the if form here, it will be called every time it is checked. So let's say the value of the expression ends up in the else block. The expression, if it's a function, it will be called three times. Once here, once here, once here, okay? But in the select, it will be called once, and that's it. So that's the main difference. In the select case, you can a value can be also an expression. Okay, so you can call a function or do a computation, use operators in the case. Case here, for example, select func a. So I'm calling function a, okay. This will return a value, and I'm calling another function to check if the different values. So is the result of func a the same as the result of func b of 1 or func b of 2, etc. So you can use any expression in your value. But once again, just like the if this time, your case will be evaluated every time. So here, once again, if, let's say, the value returned by func a makes you fall into this case, still func b will be called twice, one here, one here, okay? If the value of func a makes you fall into this case, it will be only called once, func b. So if you do some modification in the func b function, be careful, it can be called several times. A very nice feature of the select case block is the multicase and the range. Okay, multicase, very simple. You can put multiple values in one line, okay, separated with commas. Case 1, comma 2, comma 4 will work for those three values. If the expression is 1, 2, or 4, it will execute this code. The range works a little bit the same. You need to use the 2 keyword, and then here, case 5 to 8, meaning all values between 5 and 8 being included. So here, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If the expression is one of those values, this code is executed. And of course, you can mix range and multicases like this, 10, 12 to 20, 100. And you can finish with a default. That's for the select case block. One thing you should not use is floating point numbers in select case blocks, okay? It works, but those floating point numbers will be rounded to the nearest integer, okay? So this code here will work, and this will be executed. Select 1.2, case 1.3, because 1.2 is rounded to 1 and 1.3 is also rounded to 1, this will fit, this will match, and the execute this code function will be actually called. So good practice is not using floating point numbers in select case statements. Also, this works with strings as well, so you can use a string variable here or a string expression, an expression that returns a string, and use cases that are strings that works very fine. Don't forget, the comparison in strings is case sensitive. So if you have an expression that returns a lowercase string and you are testing against an uppercase string, this will not match. Okay. Done. I'm at the end of this episode. Thank you all for watching. Once again, I wish you all a happy new year 2020, and I will see you very soon.